Hey, good morning. It's Saturday, December 11th. Throat's a little hoarse this morning, but I feel fine. Probably just do one video day, though, just to save my voice. But I want to continue what we started with yesterday. These three gifts that can literally be life-changing for you and for your family. They're huge. Last night was a little dark, so I didn't get a chance to show the first gift, which is a smile. We talked about that, how important your smile is. But this morning, it's nice and bright and sunny, and I've got the second gift for you. These three gifts literally can radically impact all of your relationships for the positive good. They'll draw you closer to God because you're dependent upon God to give you the strength to exercise them. But there could not be a more precious gift than you can give to anyone that you love than these three. So the smile, your countenance, the fact that you're thrilled to see them, you're happy to see them. But then once you smile, we need to carry that through so that they really are sure that you're happy to see them, that you're invested in them. So that's what this next gift is all about. Let me pull it out here. See, get rid of the box. Next gift is listening ears. You might be thinking, I'm kind of overplaying it here. Smile, listening ears, what's the big deal? Ears that listen, really listen. Let other people know how much you value them, especially your family. Proverbs 18:13 says this, he who listens, he who answers before listening, that is his folly and his shame. You know, we say this all the time. I don't mean to interrupt you. Well, just let me say this. Before you say anything, before you finish, let me say this. We say those kind of things, don't we? What Proverbs is telling us, what the Holy Spirit is telling us, that's a shameful act, that it's a foolish act. And again, a fool in the Proverbs, in the wisdom literature, is one who acts like that there is no God. You might believe that there is, but you don't act like there is. It's your folly and your shame if you answer before listening. I think I'm going to get rained on, but I think I can finish, so we're going to continue. Listening ears. It's a priceless gift because it communicates to the other person that you really want to know what's in their heart. Not just to get by, not just to answer so that you can listen so you can have an answer, not preparing your defense while they're still talking, but that you're taking the time, you realize that any time you have a chance to communicate with someone is a moment ordained by God for you to bring honor and glory to him. Let me restate that. Listen carefully. Any chance, any opportunity that you have to communicate with folks, but especially the people in your family, especially those, any opportunity to communicate with them is a moment ordained by God so that you can show the mercy of Christ to them. Now, do you see where listening ears are huge? Think about this with me. God ordained time so that you could hear the words this person is saying. Paul tells us in Philippians that we must have the same attitude as Christ. We do that, how do we do that? By considering others more important than ourselves in humility. Jesus came to earth in humility, giving up his godness for humanity, never getting rid of it, but actually adding his humanity to God. As one theologian says, it was addition by subtraction. So he never stopped being God, but he gave up that role of God so he could be in human flesh, so he could bring the mercy of God to us. So when I take the time to listen, I'm telling the person that I'm hearing, I'm letting them know you are important because God has called me right now to listen to you. And then not to defend myself, but to extend grace and mercy so we can really work on things. I've seen too many arguments with parents and teenagers. I've been in arguments with my teenagers, much to my shame. Well, all I'm trying to do is prove that I'm right or let them know that they're wrong. And I don't really hear them. What God wants me to do is hear them. We can talk about the right or wrong after we hear. Maybe I'm the cause of the problem. But when I'm angry or upset, I never take the time to listen. I just want to get my point across. Proverbs 18:2 is just as condemning. It says, a fool, a person not interested in following God, takes no pleasure in understanding, but delights in erring in his own opinions. You see, when someone starts talking, I immediately start thinking, how can I delight? How can I get my own words out? How can I let them know that I really know more about this than they do? Or that, how can I let them know that they're wrong? Your perception is all wrong. You need to listen to me. I'm going to tell you. You get the point. See, that's not caring for a person. That's lording it over them. Proverbs 18:13 says, don't answer before you listen. Listen because you know God has ordained this moment for you to hear the person you're talking to. That has the capacity to revolutionize our life and our communication. When someone knows that I really, really care, I put aside my own upset, my own angst, my own worries, my own need to be important, and just take the time to listen. And then we can bring biblical truth to whatever needs to be done. But the first thing I have to do is to listen. Listening ears. It's a beautiful gift to give to your family, to your children, because they know that you care about them. They know that God cares about them because you listen and not take control. Don't listen with the idea of how to defend yourself. Listen with the idea of how to bring honor and glory to God. Beautiful, beautiful gift. And on Monday, we'll talk about pleasant words. But that smile, and then ears that listen, life-changing gifts. Thanks so much for being here this morning, because I won't be back tonight, rest my voice. But we'll see you on Monday, Lord willing. Check us out at everydaytalk247.com. You can, if you haven't subscribed, consider doing that. Turn on post notifications. The videos will come right to you. Again, love your comments and feedback and support. And again, Lord bless you. 2 weeks to Christmas. Listen well to those you love. Have a great day.